Let us consider having an e-commerce firm that generates its invoices in HTML. These invoices can be rendered in separate images for the sake of ease of representation in report files and presentations. You can use GC Imaging API to convert a batch of HTML files to an image format like JPEG or PNG. Let's see how to do that. We will begin by creating a .NET Core console application in Visual Studio 2022. Targeting .NET 6 framework. Add the HTML file to be converted to image format to your project. And configure it for code access. Open the NuGet Package Manager using the Tools options from the menu bar. In the Manage NuGet Packages dialog, search for grapecity.documents.html package and install the package in your project. In the Solution Explorer, expand the dependencies and the packages folders to find the NuGet package installed in the project. Let's implement the first scenario, that is, saving an HTML file to an image. Firstly, add the necessary namespaces to the project, including grapecity.documents.html and system.drawing, which will be required for all conversion scenarios. Next, define the HTML file URI. Initialize an instance of the GC HTML browser class, passing the browser path into the constructor. Generate an HTML page, that is, an instance of the HTML page class, using the new page method of the GC HTML browser class, which represents the HTML page to be converted to an image. This method accepts the HTML page URI and the page options class instance as a parameter, where page options sets the background color and the window size for the image. Invoke the save as JPEG method of the HTML page class, passing the image file name and an instance of the JPEG options class used to set image settings as a parameter to render the HTML file as a JPEG image. Run the application and view the image you just created from the HTML file. The next scenario would be converting HTML content to an image. Sometimes a company's logo as text needs to be rendered on an image, and HTML provides a rich and well-known formatting model for this. And sometimes you need to just render this HTML string to an image. Let's see how to do that. Create a variable to hold the HTML content string. Initialize an instance of the GC HTML browser class, passing the browser path into the constructor. Generate an HTML page, that is, an instance of the HTML page class, using the new page method of the GC HTML browser class as passing HTML content string and the page options class instance as a parameter, where page options sets the background color and the window size for the image. Invoke the save as JPEG method of the HTML page class, passing the image file name and an instance of the JPEG options class used to set image settings as a parameter to render the HTML content on the JPEG image. Run the application to add the HTML string of a company logo to an image. View the generated image to see the transformation. Lastly, consider a scenario where sometimes you may also need to render an entire web page to an image to annotate the images with certain additions and share them with stakeholders. Let's see how to do that using GC Imaging. Create a URI variable that holds the URI to the web page. Initialize an instance of the GCHTML browser class, passing the browser path into the constructor. Generate an HTML page, that is, an instance of the HTML page class, using the new page method of the GCHTML browser class, passing the web page URI and the page options class instance as a parameter, where page options sets the background color and the window size for the image. Invoke the save as JPEG method of the HTML page class, passing the image file name and an instance of the JPEG options class used to set image settings as a parameter to render the HTML content on the JPEG image. Run the application and render the web page to an image. View the generated image to observe how a web page has been rendered as an image. This covers various scenarios of converting HTML to an image. Interested in learning more? Head to www.grapecity.com/documents-api-imaging.